main basis of this whole case was the mobile phone conversation between the accused and the conspirators. Uska call data record hi pura nikal liya tha hamari investigating agencies ne aur wo court mein produce kiya tha. Ye bada landmark judgment hai Supreme Court ka. State of NCT, National Capital of Territory of Delhi versus Navjot Sandhu alias अफजल गुरु. अफजल गुरु का ही नाम नवजोत संधु भी था. ये 2005 सुप्रीम कोर्ट का जजमेंट है जहां पर अ डिविजन बेंच ऑफ द सुप्रीम कोर्ट हैज हेल्ड विद द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ दीज इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉल डेटा रिकॉर्ड्स टू कंफर्म द गिल्ट ऑफ द अक्यूज. डिफेंस ने कहा कि सब इस कॉल डेटा रिकॉर्ड के साथ सेक्शन 65B सब क्लॉज 4 का सर्टिफिकेट तो है ही नहीं, इसलिए ये कॉल डेटा रिकॉर्ड एंड डिजिटल जो डॉक्यूमेंट है, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डॉक्यूमेंट है, इट इज नॉट एडमिसिबल बाय द कोर्ट. ब्रिलियंट लॉयर्स फ्रॉम डिफेंस. They pointed out the non-compliance of 65B subclause 4. But in the judgment of State NCT Delhi versus Navjot Sandhu, the court came to the conclusion stating that the certificate under section 65 subclause 4 is not necessary in certain cases, and if the documents produced before the court as evidence are otherwise admissible under section 63, 64 and 65, conventional method, then 65(4) compliance is not necessary. So those documents were declared to be admissible, although that situation changed. It took 9 years to change that situation. And the Supreme Court with a 3-judge bench in the year 2014 overruled that judgment, stating that the compliance of 65 subclause 4 certificate is mandatory. Without that, the electronic evidence is not admissible in the court. And that was the judgment of Anwar PV versus P.K. Bashir, 2014 Supreme Court. As on today, this Anwar P.V. versus P.K. Bashir holds field. This judgment is the law of the land, that the compliance of 65B subclause 4 is mandatory if you want to produce any electronic document. Without certificate, it is not admissible. So as on today, this holds field. Although, let me tell you, recently, last week, the Supreme Court, it's an unreported situation as of now, maybe within coming days it may be reported also, the Supreme Court is again reconsidering Anwar PV's judgment and maybe falling back upon Navjot Sandhu's judgment. Because in the recent last week, a bench comprising Justice U.U. Lalit has held that in certain cases, an electronic evidence can be admissible without a certificate or compliance of 65(4). So our Supreme Court keeps changing its stances and making life difficult for us lawyers, because there's no consistency in their perception, and then we are feeling flummoxed. If we are not updated every day, then situation changes. Isi tarah 2005 mein Calcutta High Court has come up with a unique, at that time unique, now it is very common. That was the first judgment of Amitabh Bagchi versus Anna Bakchi, 2005 Calcutta, where the Calcutta High Court has held that the husband who was living in America and the wife has moved a maintenance application before the Calcutta court, and the deposition of the husband has to happen. And Calcutta High Court, when it was challenged because the husband could not come from America to India to do the deposition, so the matter went up to the High Court, and the High Court said that the deposition and cross-examination can take place through teleconferencing. It is not necessary for the person to travel and come to the court from US because it's practically not possible. Now it is very common that through teleconferencing we keep doing these depositions and cross-examinations. But at that time in 2005, Calcutta High Court judgment was the landmark, which was reconfirmed by Bombay High Court in 2015. In the judgment of Suvarna Rahul Musle versus Rahul Prabhakar Musle, Bombay High Court has held that the deposition and cross-examination can take place through teleconferencing if it's practically not possible for the party to appear in the court due to distance, due to lack of leaves, etc., due to exorbitant costs involved. So to simplify things, again, electronic methods are taken service of by the courts. The courts are opening to these electronic services. Now, moving ahead, Madras High Court mein 2008 mein ek litigation pahuncha jisme husband wife ke jhagde ki audio recording produce ki gayi by CD. The family court refused to take cognizance of this audio recording, saying that this can be tampered with. What is the authenticity? So matter went to the Madras High Court, and Madras High Court has held that even that audio recording can be taken into consideration provided the opportunity of cross-examining the other side is given to the other side. Agar audio CD ko aap admissible karna chahte hain, to us audio CD ke content ko cross-examine hak dusre party ko milna chahiye. In conditions pe ye audio bhi admissible ho sakta hai. Now the methods have moved ahead from 2008. Now forensics of those DVDs are necessary, or pen drive, or the method. Now, mind you here, the interesting factor is, 2006 mein, in the case of Jagjit Singh versus the state of Haryana, 2006 Supreme Court, another very interesting factor of electronic evidence. Haryana ke Vidhan Sabha ke chunao mein NCP ka ek candidate jeet gaya. Ek hi jeet gaya. Puri party ka representative ek hi. Isi tarah se ek wahan ki local party ka candidate jeet gaya. Aur 3-4 independent candidate jeet gaye. और इन सब लोगों ने मिलकर हरियाणा की एक पार्टी को सपोर्ट करके उसका चीफ मिनिस्टर बना दिया, जिसने 4 साल तक रूल किया, 2000 से 2004 तक. 2004 तक ये महानुभावों में थोड़ा गुस्सा आ गया कि हमको कुछ नहीं मिल पा रहा है, तो इन्होंने सपोर्ट विड्रॉ कर लिया और इंडियन नेशनल कांग्रेस को ज्वाइन करने का स्टेटमेंट टेलीविजन पर दे दिया. अब सिचुएशन ये बनी कि अगर आपको पता हो कि इलेक्शन पिटिशन अगर फाइल करनी है और अगर एंटी डिफेक्शन लॉ देखना है तो शेड्यूल 10 ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया में एंटी डिफेक्शन लॉ दिया हुआ है. एंटी डिफेक्शन लॉ कहता है कि अगर किसी पार्टी के लेस देन 1/3 लोग डिफेक्ट होते हैं तो उनकी सदस्यता भंग हो जाएगी. अब जिस पार्टी का एक ही कैंडिडेट जीता है वो तो 100% डिफेक्शन हो रहा है. एनसीपी में 1/3 करोगे कैसे, वो एक ही तो कैंडिडेट है और वो डिफेक्ट हो रहा है, तो वो शेड्यूल 10 में फंस नहीं रहा. वो कह रहा मैं तो मेरी पार्टी को लेके जा रहा हूं, पूरी की पूरी एनसीपी को ही उसने जाके इंडियन नेशनल कांग्रेस में मर्ज. आई एम द ओनली वन, आई एम द होल पार्टी.